Hello everyone. So right now we want to trace out another basic pencil sketch for us to make a panel sketch. Because before you can make a panel sketch, it has to be penciled. And we already have a pencil sketch pattern on this basic sketch pattern, which has both straight sketch and pencil sketch here. Panel is a vertical line that you see on a dress, on a blouse, that you see on a blouse. That's panel. Any line that you see, any vertical line, straight line, up, down line that you see on a skirt, on a blouse, or on a dress is panel. It's panel. So that's the kind of skirt we want to make now. And before you make a panel skirt, you are expected to have penciled it. So after penciling the skirt, then you now panel it. But we want to trace it. You know, this is a master busy skirt pattern, which has the straight skirt and pencil skirt pattern inside. You can see I have placed a separate brown paper. You can see I put a brown paper, a plain brown paper underneath it. I want to trace the pencil sketch. I don't have to draft a pencil sketch again, all over again. Start drafting basic sketch pattern again. No, it's the same pattern that we have done before, which is a master pattern that I will use. I will just trace how the pencil sketch that I need. I'll trace it on this plain brown paper. Then I will use this one for my panel skirts. So that's the essence of one of the advantages of pattern drafting. And just trace out. So let's start tracing out. Let's start tracing out. I'm tracing out the back pattern first. With the tracing wheel. Remember the last time we did that? In the wrist lamp. Trace the dot. Don't forget to trace the dots. The heat line for the back. Okay. So let's trace the front pattern. Waist for the front. Okay. hem for the front. The center front. Okay, so make sure you have traced everything before you remove your master pattern. This is the pattern. I can see it here, but for your, so that you can see it, let me just rule it, the traced line, let me rule it so that you can see it, just for you to see, let me rule it, like we did the other time. This place is curvy, so just follow the trace line. Follow the line. Can't use ruler for this place. Likewise, this other side. Just follow the trace line.
for waistline for the front. Center front.
So label everything, make sure you label everything. This is center back is CB, from here all the way down to the hem is center back. From the waistline at the side is side back SB, SB, all the way to the hem is SB, and this M, this is M. This is hip line for the back, and this is the waistline for the back. Always label your pattern. Okay, for the front, this is the hem. This is the hem for the front. From waistline to the hem is side, the side of the front. So we can say side front or SF. 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 This is the hip line for the front. This is the waistline for the front. And from the waistline to the end, at this side is center front, which you can call CF. CF. CF, center front, CF, CF. Okay, so this is a pencil skirt pattern right now. We want to panel it now so that we can make our panel skirts. So for you to panel, you know, I said earlier that panel is a vertical line that you see on a dress, on a skirt, or on a blouse. So any vertical line you see on a dress, on a skirt, or a blouse, just know that it's panel. So for you to panel the skirt, you align your ruler to the middle line. Align your ruler with the middle line of this dart. This is the middle line of this dart. So, first of all, do the back pattern before you go to the front pattern. So, go to the back dart, the skirt dart at the back. Look at the middle line of the dart. Align your ruler with it and rule down. I think I will need a bigger ruler, a longer ruler. And rule down. Align your ruler with the middle line, with this middle line of the dart, and rule it down, straight down to the end of the skirt. Let your ruler be straight, let your hand be straight. Make sure it aligns with the middle line of the dart. So that's the vertical line. That's the vertical line. And go to the front pattern. Do the same thing. Align your ruler with the middle line of the dots at the front. And you're going to continue the line, the middle line, straight down to the end. Make sure it aligns. Make sure your ruler is straight, your hand is straight. So that's it. We have paneled this right now. So we have four panels now. Two panels at the back, two panels at the back, two panels at the front. So from the front, we need the one that the first one, which has the center front, we label it one in circle one. This is the one that has the side for the front. The side front is labeled two. We go to the back. The one that has the side, the back, the side at the back, side back, that's SB. We label it three. And the one that has the center back, we label it four. So we have four panels right now. We have four panels right now. So we are going to be separating them. We have to cut them out. We have to cut them out. So what we'll be doing is, you know, just the same process. You can first of all cut out the back pattern before you cut out the front pattern. Then you now cut out the panels. So let's cut out the back pattern first. So this is the back pattern. This is the back pattern. So let's go to the front pattern. So as you can see, we have the two patterns. We have the back pattern, and the front pencil skirt pattern. Remember, we have paneled it into four panels. 1, 2, 3, 4. So let's cut out the first two panels. So you will put your scissors from the hem. You cut it up, just follow the line from the middle line of the back part. Just keep going to separate the first panel from the second one. So once you get here to the bottom of the end of the dart, you will now go this way. You will go this way and you will go this way. You don't have to follow the middle line. No. Once you get here, just at the bottom of the dart, go to the left, the line at the left, and go to the line at the right. You would have removed the dart, the 1-inch dart. So let's go to the first half inch of the dart, which is on the left side. because spaniel doesn't have that. Spaniel skirt doesn't have that, so we have to remove it. Spaniel skirt does not have that. Then see the first panel, it still has the dark, so we have to cut off the other side of the dark so that the dark should be removed, the 1 inch dark should be removed totally. So we have removed the dark. You know, this is the dark. This is the dark. The 1 inch dart. So we don't need it in panel skirts. We have removed it. So we have our first two panel. We have our first two panel. This is how it will look. So this is our first two panels. You can see the space for the dart is here. You can see the space of the dart is here. You remove it. Panel skirt doesn't need that. So let's cut the remaining 3 and 4 panel. So from the hem, the line that's you roll down from the middle line of the dart to the end. You start cutting the separate panel 3 and 4. Once you get to the end of the darts, you go this way. You won't continue with the middle line again. You go to the left side. The first 5.5 inches of the darts. And we have our panel 4. So let me move the old dart. So our panel 3. So go to the right side of the darts. You have the other 1/2 inch on the right side. Also, we have removed the darts at the back. We don't need the dart for panel skirts. So we have all our panels ready, and so you can see the space for the darts. Space of darts is there. So we don't need that for panel skirts. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 panels. The beauty about panel skirts is this. If you want to do mix and match color blocking, you can use this panel skirt to do it. Like, for instance, if you want yellow, maybe the front to be yellow, the back to be black, you can place this first two panel, which is the front, for the front, on yellow fabric and place the remaining 3 and 4, which is the back, on black fabric. If you want to mix maybe Ankara and lace, different fabric or anything, you can, the way you want it to mix, you can cut it, you can place each of the panel on separate fabric. You can place each of the fabric, each of the panels on separate fabric, and it will come out very nice. That's the beauty of a panel skirt or the panel skirt pattern. So in our next class, okay, before we close, let's just put the sewing allowances. And then in our next class, we'll be placing them on fabric and cutting on fabric and sewing the panel skirts. So the first one, as usual, center front CF is on fold. You place it on fold. On fold, label it on fold from the waist down to here. This side is on fold. M is 2 inches, like we did for pencil skirts. Now, this side and this side, 1 and 2, this side and this side is a joining, because we are going to be joining it together so that they will become one as and become the full front. So because it's joining, we are joining this side to this side, there will be 1/2 inch here. We'll put 1/2 inch here, we'll put 1/2 inch here. That's from waist down to hem, from waist down to hem. Use 1/2 inch to join them together. The hem of this one also is 2 inches. The side is 1 inch. 1 inch from waist down to hem. And of course the waist is 1/2 inch. The waist for panel 1 is also 1/2 inch. So that's all about the first two panels. The last two panels, panel 3, we have side back. Side is 1 inch from the waist down to hem is 1 inch. Side is 1 inch. The hem is 2 inches. Always put your sewing allowance on your pattern so that while cutting on fabric, you won't forget. And just like we did panel 1 and 2, panel 3 and 4, we'll be joining them together. At this side, we join this side to this side to make it one. I mean, to make it one as the back. So, joining is usually 1/2 inch. 1/2 inch. We'll put here 1/2 inch from waist down to hem. From waist down to hem, 1/2 inch all the way. And then center back is 2 inches zip allowance, because that's where the zip is. 2 inches zip allowance from waist down to hem. And then the waist is 1/2 inch. The waist is 1/2 inch. The center back is 2 inches zip allowance. The hem is 2 inches. And I said this part is 1/2 inch because you'll be joining this part with panel 3. Panel 4 and panel 3, they'll be joined here. So this side is 1/2 inch. The waist for this one also is 1/2 inch. Side back is 1 inch and end is 2 inches. So in our next class, we'll be placing them on fabric and we'll cut them and then sew the panel skirts. See you in the next class.